I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make cool animations like the ones you're seeing on the screen by using a program called Manim. Now, in order to do this, I'm going to be breaking the tutorials up into 8 separate videos. The first one is going to cover how to move things around on the screen, and a couple of the other videos are going to go over the 2D graphing aspect of just simple graphs, and then further down the track, we'll be going over some complex animations involving lots of updaters and value trackers. I'm also going to be covering some linear algebra things, so vectors and linear transformations on a 2D plane. We're also going to have a look at how to handle the 3D scene in Manim, so it's looking at how the screen moves around, and then we're going to move on to, later in the tutorial series, some more complex animations in 3D. I'm going to go over some probability simulations and how to construct those with loops, because using loops is the powerful part of Manim, because it is programmatic, it is built on Python. And the last tutorial is going to be guested by Manim Explained, and he's going to be covering the time updaters by using and explaining his pendulum animation. Now, because anything in programming can be tricky, the Manim community has got a Discord where there are lots of people who are willing to answer your tough questions. Let's jump into the first part of the tutorial. Suppose I want to create a code where I've just got a box moving around the screen. The syntax that I'm going to use is box.animate.shift, and then I'm going to give it a time for how quickly I want the animation to last. For the purposes of this animation, I've added a number plane with the background screen, and I've also got a dot in the center of the box as a reference point so you can see how it's shifting around the screen. Just like it says in the code, we've got a rectangle with all of those parameters that have been met, that is the color of the rectangle and the fill color. And when we animate it, we're shifting it to the right 2 units, up 3 units, down and left 5 units, and then up 1.5 units, and to the right a single unit. Notice in the code that I've given the height of the rectangle 1 and the width of the rectangle 1. You can see on the number plane in the kind of Manim background screen that the rectangle has a width of 1 and a height of 1. And it's moving around just like I've had it to self.play. Having a look at a different code, let's say I want to put many things onto my screen. So an axis, a circle, and a triangle. And I want to shift them onto the screen exactly where I want them before I start animating. Now here you can see I've created an axis, which is the sort of stuff you'd put a graph on. And I'm shifting it to the left edge, hence that line on 6 that says axis.toEdge. And then I'm creating a circle by what I've written in line 8, and then in line 10, after the customizations, I've set the width to 2, so that means the diameter of the circle will be 2, and I've put it to the edge DR, which stands for downright. I've also created a triangle. I've set the height to be 2, which means that it should go from base to top by 2 units, and I've shifted it down 3 units and to the right 3 units, which is a shifting of the center of the object. Once creating these objects to put onto the screen to animate, I'm going to then animate them with the self.play syntax. I want to write the axis. I want the circle to be drawn and then filled. I want to animate the circle so that it's going to shift the diameter to have 1 unit. And then I'm going to transform the circle into the triangle. And all of these objects should appear on the screen exactly where I've told them to from the code above the self.play animation. It's also worth pointing out the little buff statement that you can make. So for example, in line 6, axis.toEdge left, comma, buff equals 0.5. It just means that it's got a buffer in from the left by half a unit. Watch it again, try and read the code and understand how and why all of these objects are positioned on the screen exactly where they are. I'm going to move on to another scene where now we're going to be using updaters. So I'm going to start by creating a rectangle, a rounded rectangle with some customizations, and I'm going to shift it up 3 units to the left 4 units. I'm going to include some latex, which is just a simple equation to say that a 3/4 is equal to 0.75. And I'm going to change the color where I want it to be a gradient from green to pink. And I'm going to customize the height. Now where I want this text to sit is in the middle of the rectangle. And when this rectangle moves around, I want the equation to stay at the dead center of the rectangle. So the way I'm going to do that is in line 10, I've got mathtext.addUpdata, and it's by a lambda function where I'm saying always stay within the rectangle or the center of the rectangle. I'm then going to play this animation by fading in the rectangle, writing the equation, and I'm going to move the rectangle around. And what should be happening is that the text stays within the rectangle, and then I'm going to clear the updaters. I'm going to move the rectangle again, and what should be happening is that the rectangle moves, but the text stays where it is now on the screen. I do strongly encourage you to just pause and look at the code and try and understand exactly why and how things are moving around on the screen exactly how they are. We're going to talk through the code of this animation here. Now, in order to do something like this, we need to be adding a value tracker, which in my case, I'm going to call it R. R for radius, which is tracking the radius of the circle. So I've created a circle and I've used a function here called alwaysRedRaw, which is sort of like adding an updater without the ability to clear the updater, but that's fine for this animation because I don't really want to clear the updater. I want the circle to be constantly updated by the value of the radius. So by doing that, I'm saying, hey, circle, when you are when you're calculating the radius, make sure it's the value of R. So I've got R.getValue, and you know, I just add some customizations to it. Then I've also got that radius line that we saw. Again, this is always red raw. So this always red raw is like an always update me. Okay, it's an updater function, again, without the ability to clear the updater, but most of the time, I don't really care. So again, here, I want this line of the radius to go from the circle, the center of the circle, to the bottom of the circle, or to the left or to the right, it doesn't really matter. I just wanted mine to go from the center of the circle to the bottom of the circle. That way, this line is always being updated, so when the circle is moving, when it's getting smaller or bigger, the line will always go from center to bottom. So even if it gets bigger, stays at the center, goes to the bottom, or even if it's moving around to the left or to the right of the screen. Now, in this case, I also had a circumference line. So you've got, again, a third updater here. So always red raw of the line of the circumference, okay? Where I want it to have a stroke color of yellow. That one was because I wanted it to have the same color as the circle. And again, I've got some customizations. Now here I'm going set length. So I'm changing the length of the circle, and it's always being updated. That's what this always red raw function is doing. It's always updating it. So it's 2 times r.getValue. So it's sort of like saying 2 r and then times by pi. So it's like 2 pi r, which we know that's equal to the circumference. And that's going to be the length of the line. And I want it to always be next to the circle down from it with a buff of 0.2. So that buff is sort of like, here's your circle, and here's the line, like 0.2 units, put the line down there. Okay, lastly, I've also got a triangle. Again, I'm always red raw, so it's always being updated, where it's a polygon, but I want this to be a triangle, where it goes, we've got a line or one of the vertices from the top of the circle to the left of the circle to the right of the circle. So it's hitting here, here, and then here. So we're gonna have a triangle that stays in the circle, and it's always red raw, so it's always being updated. Okay, then we're going to finally play our animation out with this line here, and then I want to make a replacement transform. So I'm really saying circle, make a copy of the circle, which is this guy here, and make that circle transform into the circumference. So it sort of looks like the circle is becoming the circumference. That's one of the nice things with Manim. It's got this transform as a play animation, and it makes things look really cool. And then where all the magic's happening is in the last line of the code, where I'm saying r.animate.setValue to 2. So really this is saying set the radius equal to 2. And take 5 seconds. So the radius is gonna go from 0.5, which is what it was originally, all the way up here, and then go all the way to have a radius of 2.